This is a 1964 Tripp 29 built in Holland. We've got some really nice classic lines to it. Just brought it back from Chesapeake Bay here to Brunswick, Georgia for refitting. It's already got the old Atomic 4 removed, and it has overhanging transom that we can fit an outboard well in, similar to the Allberg 30, the Triton, and Pearson Vanguard and similar boats. He's got external lead ballast, so that's not crack, that's just the joint between the fiberglass and the ballast with bronze keel bolts inside, so that's no problem. Very similar to the Triton and Allberg 30, but it's got some differences, a little bit of tumble home. The bilges are a little more slack, more of an overhang, and a flatter transom that curves around to the sides. The red paint on the top sides was brushed on several years ago, but apparently underneath it was also red gel coat. On deck, it's the original gel coat, and the boat's still in good shape after over 50 years, because it's been in covered storage for many years before I got it, and before that it was also kept in storage in the winter inside. So up here on the deck, most of the deck fittings are off. Previous owner was making repairs and preparing for paint. The teak tow rail is still good. So is the forward hatch. The mast is keel stepped, so it goes through there. And it's got a teak eyebrow and handrails. And the cockpit is a little different than we're used to. The tiller and the rudder are further forward. So back here, we're going to have to modify this area for the outboard well. So I think we'll cut this section out, raise it up to about this level, right across there, and put the outboard well here. Bring this forward with the lid to open for access for the outboard well. And two cockpit lockers. The old engine control panel with the compass mount probably should be cut out and filled in flat here. And you can see the companionway is much wider than on the Allberg boats, but the coach roof is more narrow with wider side decks. So that's peculiar to this design, this Bill Tripp design. So there's the wide companionway, good ventilation there. And the bridge deck is nice and high, so it's still safe at sea. Here's the main salon. You can see the way they've got it set up is they've got a sink, deep sink to port, and storage, dish lockers and such. Engine compartment used to be here. Now the batteries could go back there. This was the original fridge. Some people have left this as a storage locker and closed this one off and mounted a stove there. I've just taped up into place temporarily the cabinetry pieces. The previous owner had everything stripped out for some repairs. Here's a nice big table. It folds down here and it slides on that pipe over to the center. And under the bilge is a water tank in the center area, built integral into the hull. Mast steps down here from there. Closed locker to starboard. Enclosed head to port. This is a nice head, except it's very cramped, so I would remove this cabinetry here forward and enlarge that. I mean, you don't need a second sink 4 steps away from the other sink, I wouldn't think. And the V-berth. Cushions are all okay, just need slip covers. And the chain locker, good size. These fixed port lights here in the front, nice to have one facing forward for visibility. The two in the center are opening. So she needs paint and then a new electrical and plumbing and a few other jobs, but no big work needed in here.